to another clay video. Today, we are going to make a fully functioning ocarina from the Ocarina of Time. This has got to be one of the craziest things I've made with clay. I don't know anything about ocarinas, and I definitely don't know anything about making ocarinas, so every step of this was a big learning process, and it took a lot of trial and error. At first, I just wanted to make the ocarina like this, cut it in half, and hollow out the two sides, but that ended up not really working, and they didn't really keep their shape, they got really messy, and I decided to just bake these two halves instead. So my next idea was to bake these first and then hollow them out, but as you can see, it didn't work very well and it ended up just breaking a lot. So I'm gonna use these as sort of like a reverse mold. Usually a mold, you fill things into the center of it, but this one, the mold is going to be in the center and we're gonna coat the outside. So I'm using this extra waste clay. This is just leftovers from a lot of other projects. And I'm gonna coat the outside of this with it into the right shape and trim it down. And now we can throw this into the oven. Since baked clay doesn't really stick too well to unbaked clay, it's really easy to get this mold out of the center. And this looks actually really good, so let's just do the same thing to the other half. And this is our shell of the ocarina. So let's start creating the mouthpiece. I figured that using a popsicle stick would make it wide enough, hopefully to get enough airflow into it. And we're gonna cut it at a slant to make it a lot easier to attach onto the body of the ocarina. Now we need to cut a hole which is going to transfer the wind from the mouthpiece into the ocarina. And this seems to be big enough, so let's attach on the mouthpiece. I just sort of lightly blended this on with my fingers. So we have this little hole beneath the mouthpiece, and this is the voicing. This is basically where the sound and the excess air comes out of. Now we need to cut this slant or this slope to be a 45 degree angle, but as you can see, this baked clay gets really messy when you try to trim it down, so I'm just gonna take this out and I'm gonna use some raw clay and just make the slant myself. So this actually looks pretty good. Let's get this to be slanted. And as you can see, we get some wind, but not much beyond that. And I think it's because the mouthpiece, where the wind comes down, didn't really hit it in the middle. As you can see in that diagram, the wind is supposed to go into the ocarina and then split in half. Half of it going outside and half of it going inside the ocarina. So I'm gonna use some duct tape just to really seal up the edges of it. This won't be a permanent thing, this is just temporary to test it out. We finally got a successful sound, so let's glue these two pieces together. And now we can take some extra clay to seal up the edges, and this should hopefully have a perfect seal where no air escapes. After we've sealed up all the cracks on the ocarina, it's time to start drilling the holes. So we got the ocarina to make some sound, but we need to make the different finger holes so we can make all of the different notes. So I'm gonna be using this drill with some different sized drill bits, and to make sure the notes are perfect, I have this tuner on the phone. This is a C5. That's going to be the lowest note on the ocarina, and the rest of them will just go higher from there. After maybe 20 or 30 minutes of drilling holes and trying to get it into the right tuning, we finally have a bunch of notes on the ocarina. I read that Fimosoft is a non-toxic clay, but my lips are tingling after playing it for a while, so hopefully after I paint it and glaze it, that won't be an issue anymore.
I'm taking some silver clay for one final detail before baking. This is the little silver wrapping that's around the top of the ocarina, and we need to sketch out a little Triforce symbol on there using this dentist pick. And I'll be painting all these details after we bake it. And this little middle part of the Triforce needs to be dented in. So now our ocarina is ready to get baked. After baking the ocarina, it's time to get painting. So I'm using this blue and white mixture to get a nice light blue color. This looks like a pretty good color, so let's choose our paintbrush. It's a lot of paintbrushes for somebody who pretty much never paints. Now taking the blue paint, we just need to cover the entire ocarina. I think it took about 3 coats of this paint to fully cover it, so you didn't see any of the clay underneath it. I also made sure to get in all of these little spots on here, and now the mouthpiece. I noticed the paint started to build up on the edge of the holes, and also you could see inside the hole all of the colors of the clay, so I decided to just stick that in there with a Q-tip. Now using a silver paint marker, instead of using some paint because it's very hard to get in these little areas with a paintbrush, and I'm not very precise with painting. So luckily I could use these paint markers. Now that's all the painting details done, so let's take some Fimo gloss varnish. And this is something I have rarely done with my clay figures, but for the ocarina I think that it looks really good. I'm just covering the entire ocarina except the silver parts with 1 coat of this gloss varnish. Luckily, unlike the paint, you only have to do 1 coat. And that is our final detail, so here it is, the Ocarina of Time. I hope you all enjoyed the creation of the Ocarina of Time. I wasn't able to get it into a proper tuning. I wanted to make it into a C ocarina, but that didn't really happen. So it can play a lot of different types of notes. I just don't really know the order, so I can't look up a chart or a tutorial of how to play certain songs. So here's just a little bit of what I figured out you can do with the ocarina. That last note's a little bit rough. I think there's just too much wind going on at that point. But I also found you can make this really cool sound by lifting your finger on and off really fast. That's about all I've learned so far with the ocarina, and without a proper tuning, I don't really know that I'll be able to learn a lot of songs, but it would be cool to get a real ocarina and maybe try to learn the different songs from the Ocarina of Time. Also, my lips aren't tingling anymore after putting the paint and the glaze on, so I guess that made it more safe. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all in the next one.